Welcome back to another episode of Ayums. We got a big day ahead of us, looking for a volcano. I'm gonna grab a handful of potatoes. That did not seem to be working right. It's only taking one. I thought I could take 10. Oh no, I did not want to do that. What? No, I don't need that many potatoes. Alright, well, I was thinking like 30 would be all I need. Alright, 30 potatoes. We'll just grab whatever's out of the oven real quick. I don't really need to carry all this stuff with me, but shouldn't matter. I'll grab some cucumbers real quickly as we go. Just to have those on hand, and I expect there'll be vegetables out here someplace that I can munch on as well, like right here, some wild tomato. We got some rhubarb. We'll just rip that up forcefully by its roots. Got some cucumber over there, some pumpkins. I actually don't know what I can do with pumpkins. Somehow you have to split them into slices, I think. But I've never heard of anybody eating pumpkin raw. I mean, please, if you eat pumpkin raw, let me know in the comments. I won't laugh at you, I've never heard of that being a thing. So I assume it's not. But obviously I could be wrong. Out of food so quickly. It's all that sprinting, I tell you. I don't remember how far away this volcano was. I just remember there being one. And hopefully I can find it. I'm still seeing my trail of torches, so we're good on that. A jungle? Do I remember going through a jungle? Not particularly, but oh no, you know what? If I was traveling during the day, I probably didn't put any torches out. Because why would I? This is a very bad idea. I need to go back. I need to not get lost. Which means I should just travel straight in one given direction. I don't know which direction. I don't know if it really makes too much of a difference. Oh, almost fell in the hole. But yeah, I should definitely not be trying to follow a trail that doesn't exist as a trail. Because I probably only put torches out during the night. Okay, There's my casa. Y mi casa es su casa. My house is definitely not your house. Don't even think about it, buddy. Don't even think about it. Like, my teeny little house is barely enough to hold me. Definitely not enough space for, 662 subscribers to come live in, or 65, 600, it's somewhere around that number. At the time of this recording, which is like 4 weeks prior to its publishing, because that's the way I roll, you know. Starving again. Oh, I should try to get some jungle saplings. And yeah, let's do that by cutting down non-jungle leaves. That's genius. Probably the smartest thing I've done this whole episode. No, actually the smartest thing I did was going back to my house so I wouldn't get lost. Of course, now I'm gonna get myself all turned around out here. I can barely reach any of these leaves. I'm probably not gonna get a sapling that way. No, definitely no saplings. Okay, well, that wasn't the main objective of this quest, so I'll just continue on. We have a big lake. All right, well, I mean, I suppose I could get some pine saplings if possible. Those might be handy to have, in case I ever want some pine wood. Okay, this whole finding a volcano idea, it's probably not great. I just feel like I'm gonna get lost and not be able to find my way back. Which would not be good, seeing as how my whole life's work is in that house. That might be being a little overly dramatic, but still. No pine saplings? I need a pine sapling, or two, or three, or 12. I mean, any amount, really. I need some. Pretty please. Okay, well, until one of you pine trees gives up some of your saplings, I'm just gonna have to keep killing you all. But don't worry, I'm a good lumberjack. I will replace what I remove. Ooh, there a sapling is. But now I feel bad for not completely removing this. Oh wait. Oh, is it this trunk that's keeping that up? That could be. Okay. Let's grab the sapling. Am I really just gonna get. Oh, here we go. That's more like it. And, you know, I'd replant the pine tree. Yeah, I will. Even though I harvested two, I'm only replanting one. Now, to get back, it's this direction, is it not? Yes, through the jungle. Ooh. Let's not get distracted here and get lost. Maybe fell a jungle tree. Might be able to get a sapling that way. Und zine. Yeah, I have to think of a better method of of finding a volcano. I could use the find volcano command, but I have no idea what that does. I'm assuming it just gives coordinates for the nearest volcano. This is a bad way to chop down jungle trees too, just FYI. Because now I need to place more items down here. Fortunately, I have an excellent supply of pine needles. You know, lots of stickiness, high flammability, great stackability, evidently. As is demonstrated by the fact that I'm standing on top of a pile of them. So yeah, we've got that going for us. How tall is this? There we go. I just like one sapling. I mean, four or five would be better, but one's really all I need. Because I can plant one jungle tree at my base then. And that would be enough to get some more saplings from. Theoretically, however, it doesn't always work that way. So I would like to have a handful. Sometimes you chop a tree down and you get like one sapling from it, or no saplings. In which case, I accomplish nothing. But I need to be able to replant my trees. Jungle tree saplings, where you at? Three? I chopped down a giant tree and I get three saplings? Oh, wait, here's some more. Right, right. Something fall up into these leaves, maybe? Doesn't look like it. But you know what? I'll do a good deed, and I'll just fell this tree, too. I don't know how this is a good deed, quite honestly. I don't know what's a good deed about chopping trees down. I don't get it. My inventory full? It is. Ew. Ew, gross. I need that apple. I need it so I can be sustained. I believe this is the direction I want to travel in. I hope. Nothing goes bump in the night, so I'm pretty safe. With the exception of falling in a hole and cracking my head open. I don't really remember going through woods at all. So that's not great. Oh wait, I have a body of water up ahead. Do I remember a body of water? Okay, it's pitch black. I cannot see anything. Oh, that's better. Okay. I'm gonna have to just punch my way through this forest, aren't I? Starving? I literally just ate. I don't remember a lake with jungle trees in it. This is not good. A savanna. Okay, I don't really remember being in a savanna either, but I see some light up on this hill. I'm gonna assume is from me from earlier on. So as long as I don't fall to my death in a cave. Wow, almost did exactly what I needed to not do. I need to build like a tall tower. Oh, look at that. There's like a whole little, it's like a whole little zigzaggy path. That's pretty much only visible at nighttime because these torches aren't all that visible during daylight. And there's my house. I didn't find a volcano at all. I might just line the well with some stone tile. Now isn't there like a big hole in the, yeah, right there, right in front of me. And I think there's another one. Although I could be wrong. Is that a? No, that's something that's just very dark. I don't know what. All right. That's just a small hole. The fence isn't actually done yet, but I did learn that I can do every third pillar and put a light on it. So that's excellent. Tis excellent. I'll go ahead and throw those in there. Now, at some point, I will get one of the... I don't even know what the thing's called, but there's this little tool that will, like, put the stuff in the right slots for you. And I'll eventually have one of those. So I just dump everything into one inventory, and it takes care of the rest. So everything goes where it belongs without me having to go through a bunch of work. Not that that's like a bunch of work to do, but because I can only see what's in the hotbar at that given time. It is. Ooh, my steel sword just leveled up. I wonder how my steel sword feels about leveling up from cutting down plants. Like, it's never been used in combat. I used a stone sword in combat a few episodes ago. First Taste of Blood. Episode title. I don't know what number that is. But then I broke it. Because I didn't care enough to repair it. Because I kind of wanted to get a steel sword. But I figured there was no point in having a steel and a stone sword. So I just used the stone sword up. Till it had nothing left to give. And then I built the steel one, which I will now keep and guard with my life. Well, actually, the steel sword will guard my life. little bit of a play on words there. But, yeah, I will keep it and repair it and all that good stuff. Because from what I remember when I did a mod review on that, as your tools increased in levels, they also increased in durability. So I think that if you get to a high enough level that your sword is pretty much the equivalent of a better tier weapon or tool, though I think your speed probably stays different. I'll throw those in there. Alright, well, I think I will wrap this episode up, even though I totally did not find a volcano. But yeah, I need some way to make sure I don't get lost before I try doing that. So yeah, we'll just wrap things up here. Thanks for watching. Tune in next week for another episode, and I will see you then.